Let's learn how to make a chain. Chain is abbreviated as CH and represented by this symbol on a crochet chart. Make a slip knot and transfer it onto the hook. Hold on to the slip knot made with the help of the middle finger and thumb. To begin with, make sure the hook is facing you. We will do a yarn over and pull through the loop on the hook. Turn the hook so that it is facing upwards. Moving your hook from front to back, grab the working yarn. Turn the hook in anti-clockwise direction so that it is facing downwards. This is how you do a yarn over. Once again, turn your hook so that it is facing upwards. Moving your hook from front to back, grab the yarn. Rotate the hook such that it is facing downwards. Now, draw the hooked yarn through the loop on the hook. This makes our first chain stitch. Let's repeat it a couple of times more to get a hang of it. Again, yarn over and pull through the loop on the hook. Every time you make a chain, move your fingers up to hold the last made chain. To make sure that each of the chain stitches are of the same size, move the loop on the hook up to the hook shaft while doing a yarn over. If you find that your chain is too tight and you're unable to pull through, try relaxing your hands as you might be pulling on the working yarn too tightly. Or if your chains are too loose, increase the tension over the working yarn. This is how you will make a foundation chain to start any crochet project. Once you have made your chain stitches, it's important to know how to count them. The loop on your crochet hook, as well as the slip knot made, is not included while counting the chain stitches. We will count the V-shaped structures from underneath our crochet hook until the slip knot. This is our first chain stitch, the second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, and tenth. We are not counting the slip knot. When a pattern asks for you to count the chain stitches before proceeding to the next stitch pattern, this is how you will do it.